Good morning, children. Welcome to my English class. So this is in continuation with our previous class. That's Unit 10, Purandara Dasa Part 1, the school trip to Hampi. Okay, a school trip to Hampi. So what did we learn in this lesson? The group of students are going to a picnic or a trip or an excursion to Hampi, a historical place in Karnataka. So I told you all what Hampi is famous for. All the stone carved. It is a city with rocks and stones carved temples. And so the one important, most famous temple is the temple of Vitthala, Lord Vitthala. And one more important thing, what you find there is the stone chariot, where this chariot is carved as a stone, from the stone. And then the temple is also very famous for the musical pillars. Okay, so the musical pillars are very important or aspect of the temple. So you get 7 different musical notes from the pillars of the temple, the Vitthala temple. So this was about the picnic, where the children go and they talk about, before going to the picnic, they talk about this temple. So once they go, what they do? Suraj and Mohan, when they go to they find an old building near the river bank, and they find out that that old building is the mantapa of Purandara Dasa. Purandara Dasa was a great devotee of Lord Vishnu, and he composed lot of songs in praise of Lord Vishnu. So he is a very good musician, and the statue had a tambura and a pair of cymbals in his hand, right? So Suraj wanted to know more about the story, more about Purandara Dasa. So what happens? They decide, Suraj and Mohan decide to go and ask the teacher more about Purandara Dasa. So this lesson ends over there. So now we have learned new words. I've asked you all to write the new words and the meanings of the whatever is given in the textbook. So now we will do the exercise. Answer the following in your notebook. So you have to take your classwork, 4-line notebook, and copy down whatever I'm writing along with the questions. So I'm not going to write the questions on the board. I will be writing the answers, and you will copy the question from the textbook and write the answer. Okay? Don't miss out on the questions. The question and the answer is given in the textbook, and the answers will be on the board now. So the first question is, like, for answer the following. Mohan and Suraj have gone on a trip to Dash. So where did they go? They went to Hampi. H-A-M-P-I. Hampi. Okay? Hampi. The second one, what do they see there? What did they see there? They saw an old mantapa. Mantapa. So they saw old, O-L-D, old, M-A-N-T-A-P-A, mantapa. They saw old, an old mantapa in Hampi. So the third one is, whose statue is there in the mantapa? So they saw an old mantapa. What did they see? And so we will write it as an old mantapa. That will make a proper phrase. And because old starts with a vowel, so you have to write an. An old mantapa. Mantapa. Okay? The third one, so after every answer, you have to leave a line and write the next question. Then the answer, leave a line, and then the next question. The next question is, whose statue is there in the mantapa? Whose statue was there in the mantapa, children? So they saw the statue of Purandara Dasa. P-U-R-A-N-D-A-R-A. Purandara Dasa. D-A-S-A. So the statue of Purandara Dasa. The fourth one. Is sitting with the other children. Who is sitting with the other children in the lesson? If you see the page number 117, where Suraj says the first line, Yes, it will be fun. She is sitting there with the others. Shall we go? So who was sitting there? That was the teacher. They wanted to know more about Purandara Dasa. So whom did they decide to ask? They decided to ask the teacher. So where's the teacher? Teacher was sitting with the other students. So the teacher was sitting with the other children. The teacher, T-E-A-C-H-E-R, teacher. So this is the question and answer. These are only answers. Please write the question and then write the answer. So after every answer, you have to leave a line. So complete the sentence to get answers. So second one is the complete the sentence. You children have to learn to write in cursive. So the first one, where in Hampi did Mohan and Suraj go? So they went to Hampi, but where in Hampi did they go? They went to an old mantapa. Old mantapa is the answer. So in the dash you have to write old. They went to old mantapa. The second one, what did they see in the mantapa? They saw the dash of Purandara Dasa. They saw the statue of Purandara Dasa. It's small s because it's in between the sentence. It's not the beginning of the sentence. So S-T-A-T-U-E, statue. The statue of Purandara Dasa. So what did they see in the mantapa? They saw the dash of Purandara Dasa, statue of Purandara Dasa. What did they see in Purandara Dasa's hands? What did they see in Purandara Dasa's hands? The third one, they saw the dash and the dash. The first dash is T-A-M-B-U-R-A, Tambura. They saw Tambura and the symbols. I'll write it down here. C-Y-M-B-A-L-S, symbols. So they saw tambura and the symbols. So this is tambura and symbols are the musical instrument which Purandara Dasa was holding in his hands. So what did they see? They saw the tambura and the symbols in his hands. Next one, in whose praise were the songs written unsung? In whose praise did Purandara Dasa write this song and he sung in whose praise? He sung in praise of Lord Vishnu. So they were sung in, the first dash is in, I-N, in praise of Lord Vishnu. Vishnu, V capital letter, because it's the name of a person. So that's the dash. The first dash is in and the next one is Vishnu. So the songs were sung in praise of Lord Vishnu. The next one, I will orally tell you all the answer. Please note it down and I shall send you all the photo of the same later. The third main, fill in the blanks choosing the words given in the brackets. So Michael was a dash of music. So Michael was the composer. The word is given below in the bracket, C-O-M-P-O-S-E-R, composer of music. He was dashed by music lovers. So he was praised, P-R-A-I-S-E-D, praised by music lovers. His dash is seen in many parts of the world. Statue, S-T-A-T-U-E. All these three words are given in the brackets. Please write it down in the correct place. The fourth one, use shall, will and can to complete the story given below. Mala looks at the tree from her room. The leaves are bright and green. She says, Minnie, dash shall we go and see that beautiful tree. So what is the answer over there? You have to write shall, S-H-A-L-L, shall is to ask, shall, can is all usually used in the questions. So you can say, shall we go and see that beautiful tree? So that's a question. So shall is fine. Shall we go and see that beautiful tree? Minnie says, I dash tell you the secret of the tree. So it's another dialogue phrase. I will tell you. I dash tell. I will tell you the secret of the tree. She did not look at it when she said this. It is not a real one. So Minnie was not looking at the tree when she was saying, but still she said, I will tell you the secret of that tree, because she already seen that tree. So what is the next sentence? It is a metal one. It dash not have nest in it. It cannot have nest in it. So can, C-A-N, can. So it cannot have the nest. So if it's a metal tree, no birds will come and sit on it. So they cannot have trees, nest in it. They won't build any nest, right? So the first one is shall, second is will, and third is can. Now, recreate Mohan's story and read aloud to the class. So we are recreating the story with the same shall, will, and can in it. The boys go to the teacher hoping that she dash tell them the story. She will tell them the story. W-I-L-L, will. Before starting, she claps her hand and she asks. Can you hear me? Because teacher is sitting and there'll be 30-40 students around her. They'll be far. So what she does? She claps her hand to ask whether children the children at the back should be able to hear. Children who are far away from her. So she says, can you hear me? The children say, we shall come closer. So the children who are far away from her wanted to come closer. So we dash come closer. We shall, S-H-A-L-L, shall come closer. They sit around her so that they dash hear clearly, can hear, C-A-N, can. So again we used will, can, shall, and can again. Complete the passage using has and have. Sheila madam dash a music class at home. Sheila madam has a music class at home. We dash a great fun there. We have a great fun. H-A-V-E, have. She dash taught us pillari gitegalu. Means she has taught us pillari gitegalu. H-A-S, has. She dash told us that Purandara Dasa is called the father of Carnatic music. So she has told us that Purandara Dasa is called, so has, H-A-S. Our other friends also dash joined our classroom. Also have joined our classroom. H-A-V-E, have. The next one. Now how many musical instruments can you find in this maze? So there's a maze here. You have to, it's like a crossword puzzle. Find out the musical instruments name. So that's a homework for you all. You all find out, draw lines to connect the words. Send it to me and I shall see that, okay? And then we have Purandara Dasa part 2, which we'll be doing in the next class. In this lesson, we'll be knowing more about Purandara Dasa. For the first part 1, we learned more about Hampi, the city. Now we'll know more about Purandara Dasa in this lesson. So that will be our next class. So I want you all to copy down the notes. I have written only the answers. I'm telling you all again, write the question and the answer and send the photos to me. I will correct it and send it to you all. Okay, children, take care. Have a good day.